last time, you guys made it to, what is this city's name?
Doom and Gloom.
Death, right? Death.
Move us to the right map.
Hogren. Now I'm getting there.
Oh, crap.
Yeah, I'm moving here first.
Okay.
You guys made it to Hogren, and unfortunately, we're overwhelmed by the...
I can't see anything. I deleted my token.
I know. The shadow creatures that, that you guys encountered there. You're not sure what caused them yet, but unfortunately you guys lost Asmir, Forge, and Sarek.
Well, you say unfortunately, but they were kind of insufferable.
Can we not talk about that, please?
Anyway, so we ended with Oriana stopping Eros from trying to go back in and rescue their bodies, essentially. And you guys are kind of just... Are you heading back to the cart now?
I think so. I think we were heading... No, I think what happened was Eros was flying them, because he's a giant crow at the moment, to the closest military base that our people have.
Yeah. That would be New Britain, which is 10 days back, so...
Son of a bitch.
Then I would fly us to the cart...
I think it was 10 days. Let me double check that. Is there 4G?
Oh.
yeah.
He's protecting us from a bat.
yeah, it was 10 days back. It took you guys 10 days here. So you guys can start, you want to start heading back to New Bern, basically?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you guys know that on your way here, that was the only, I mean, that was the last town you saw, because Hogren is so far north, there's not really much that further north. Okay, so you guys make it back to the cart, and you're gonna, I guess, load up and start heading back?
Yeah.
Who's driving?
Euros.
Yeah.
Asmir's driving.
Yeah, it used to be Asmir and Forge. Okay, you guys make it back to the cart, and it seems oddly empty. I mean, you still have the chest in the back of it, but you're used to it being loaded down with a bunch of people and a dragon, and they're all gone now. So you guys both sit in the front, and you both silently get in the cart. And you start moving back towards town.
The sun rises behind us, and I wrap an arm around Oriana. Making those cheesy end of movie moments.
Yeah, you ride up into the sunset. No.
Except that she's going to shrug it off and just cry.
Ooh.
Okay.
Breaking my heart, Oriana.
The blessing will.
I warned you. It's going to be rough for a while, guys.
So you guys travel until it gets dark, and you stop to make camp. And you realize that you don't have someone there to go get food, so you guys can either try to hunt for yourselves or eat the rations that were left behind for in the chest for Frostfire.
I will attempt to hunt.
Okay. Make a survival check.
I'm just gonna check if I have any magic that can assist me in this.
Okay.
And it was at this point that they realized how much they'd taken advantage of the friendships they had.
No!
You make Grace cry in real life.
Seriously, I cried in real life last time.
If I polymorph into a hunting animal, like a giant ape. I don't know.
Think giant apes hunt.
Separate,
they're actually vegetarians, though.
Separate schools.
Oh, well, then into like, I don't know, a saber-toothed cat. Can I use the saber-toothed cat's survival?
I think you get their what is survival under? Is that wisdom?
Yes, so wisdom.
I don't think you get that then.
Would I at least get advantage? Because most of those things get advantage on those checks.
Oh god, just say yes.
They're like keen smell.
JD is so done with this beginning stuff.
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah, go ahead.
Eros is trying to learn how to hunt without the party.
He's trying to provide for Oriana.
Yes.
Because he secretly knows he can't make anything better right now.
Well, I mean, I do have like 18 days worth of rations on me.
Mm-hmm.
Just because I do.
You can't
get those rations for Frostfire. That's like months for you two.
Yeah, like, you know, Zarek had picked up a bunch of extra rations for Frostfire that won't be needed now. Eros, you're just able to find a couple rabbits up here. It was pretty hard finding anything since it's so far north, but you're able to find something to take back to Oriana.
Yes.
Start making that.
Okay. You repeat this the next day, I'm guessing.
Okay. Yeah, so you guys basically go to sleep that night, not getting much sleep, and then you get back up in the morning and start moving back towards town. So you guys can spend the next day kind of going through the motions. Is there anything you guys want to talk about in that time?
I don't think there's much talking happening.
There's really not.
Okay. Why are you being such a jerk? I'm pretty sure Oriana can have her own nightmare. She doesn't need your help.
Also, did Forge have a soul?
You don't know.
Well, if he didn't have a soul, then he doesn't have a ghost?
You don't know. I will retract the statement that you guys saw something. Well, I'll say this. You saw something attack your three friends and move through them, but you're not necessarily sure that it was, like, their spirit that came from them. But, yeah, so.
Okay. So, yeah, we just head back to New Bern.
Okay. You guys make it back to New Bern, and the town is somewhat different from before. There is still work on the wall. It's made quite a bit of progress now that it's been about 20 days since you guys left. But instead of the Stoken soldiers that you saw before, you now see Krindorian soldiers working on the wall. It doesn't look like necessarily soldiers, but builders. Maybe people who are in the army that came from a building background before. They kind of check to see, to make sure that you're not coming in to attack them, but they kind of nod as you guys stroll in. And you can see, as soon as you move into the city, you can see the damage of the attack on the city, or town, it's not really a city. You see, like, burnt walls and repairs going on around town. And even on the outside of town, you could start seeing the military force that has been moved into here. Their military tents set up all around the town and inside of the town, pretty much anywhere where there's free space. And you can tell now that the full force of the army has moved into this one town and kind of taken control of it. It does look like once you guys are inside town, other than the building and repairing things and trying to clean up the town, that everyday life is kind of returned to normal, which seems odd to you because you guys feel like
literally everything has changed.
You guys feel like it's too normal, you know? From being out on your own for so long, it just seems a little too normal. So where are you guys heading?
Military barracks area, I guess?
You probably should tell somebody that everybody's dead.
Yeah, and you guys knew even though, like, the launch attack from the Arcane Library, you guys knew there's a barracks in town, so you guys can head there, and you do see more soldier tents set up out there. Just maybe do this map. And you guys are kind of knotted in. Whenever you get to the door, you'll park your cart, and you'll walk in. Who are you looking for?
Whoever seems to be in charge.
So you'll kind of ask a soldier, are you looking for, like, the High Command and the High Magus, or are you specifically looking for Shell, or...
Yes.
All of them?
Yes.
Okay. So, yeah, you'll walk up to a guard, and, he'll ask you, like, who are you here to see?
Everyone of high rank, basically. We have a very large issue in the north. If we want to take that place, we were sent for.
Oh, you guys were the group sent to Hallgren. Pretty sure the councils are going to want to talk to you. Let me inform them. And you see him run off upstairs. After a couple minutes, he comes back and tells you to follow him. And you guys are brought into what is essentially, blanked on the word. No, like a war room. Yeah, that's the word. Yeah. You can see there's several people in this room, and emissaries from Elithir are here, the older elven council, and you see them all discussing stuff over a map, and whenever you walk in, the High Commander will come up to you and ask, we didn't get a status report like we had expected. One of you guys reached a Hallgren. Is there a reason why you're back?
Everyone died.
What does that mean?
It means me and Oriana are the only survivors of the mission you sent us on.
And you, as soon as you say that, everybody kind of stops what they're doing and just kind of stares at you. And the commanders say, well, what is the status of Hallgren itself?
Full of shadows. Dark, evil things that try to kill you if you go inside.
And he'll kind of look back at everybody. So there were no survivors of Hallgren whatsoever?
Well, I mean, we didn't really get very far in before they appeared out of nowhere and slaughtered our people.
Okay. And you guys are, you see everybody standing around, and you guys do notice a, dwarven gentleman standing in the background. JD.
Huh?
Yeah.
What?
Basically, these two strangers walked into the war room where you have been helping, speak to the commander and the magus and the Elithir Council. You've been sent to talk with them because you had been looking for information on Hallgren, and two strangers walk in and basically say everybody's dead.
Oh. What? What is the meaning of this? What?
Does he not know common very well? I thought the meaning was pretty clear.
You say everyone is dead?
Well, we got, like, maybe 100, 150 feet in, and then all these shadow things came out of the walls and slaughtered everyone.
That's impossible.
It's literally not impossible. It's what just happened.
Yeah, and you guys remember that there were bodies literally, like, every room and floor that you saw.
Yeah, we didn't see any, like, living things. It was all... they were all dead.
Well, then I'm off to Hallgren.
I really, really don't recommend that.
I have to see this for myself.
Well, I mean, we should send a full group. I mean, these were a group of five with a dragon, and they didn't make it out alive, so we shouldn't just send a couple people back to check on the situation. We should send a full group. We can grab a couple more soldiers if we need to. This is what you guys need to do. Go back to your commanding officer, grab a few more from your squad, and you guys can head back up there. We kind of need to assess what this means. Did you guys, I mean, you didn't see any information on why this happened or how this happened?
Everyone was dead. Get close enough to learn anything because shadows jumped out of the walls and murdered everyone. They touched us and we died.
Well, you two didn't.
No, because I turned into a massive bird and flew us the fuck out of there.
I kind of look at you like, okay. Why don't you guys go find a place to take some time, and we'll see if we can get a couple people to go with you. Doesn't seem like it's going to be an easy sell, though, so...
We will just head out then, unless Grace wants to do anything.
No, I'm avoiding all contact with anybody right now.
While we are here, is there a place where the mages gather?
Yeah, the Arcane Library.
I would like to attempt to have them make a magic item for me.
Okay.
It's going to be another thing like what Zarek did with the Ring of Darkness.
Mm-hmm.
I want the exact opposite.
Okay. A Ring of Light?
Basically, I want a very powerful flashlight ring.
So you want a ring that casts, like, the light spell?
He wants a drift globe.
No, I want a ring that ideally casts sunlight.
Oh, that's a really powerful spell.
Yeah, I want to be able to summon a orb of sunlight. Not the spell, like a light equal to that of the sun.
Well, I'll tell you this.
I don't have enough money for that.
Too long to make.
Well,
you're also blind me.
Know that the only reason... the only reason that Zarek's items didn't take, you know, a week or whatever... is because he got five or six people to help him make it, and he also paid them for that.
How much gold
is it trying to do is...
You guys only have the gold that's on you, because the bag of holding was with Forge.
Asmir.
Yep.
Or Asmir, whoever.
So why didn't we leave that in the cart?
Asmir and Forge were swarmed. Like all the gear's on them.
The only thing you have
in the cart is five plate armors.
Yeah, the chest.
The group loot thing. We have 8 sets of plate armor, 16 javelins, and 8 great axes.
Yep, you do.
Can we sell all that?
You could.
No. Because I'm taking one of those plate armors.
You don't exist.
Yes, he does.
One of them is on him.
Yeah, he's not in our group.
He's one of those is already spoken for.
He doesn't believe the whole you have to be in the group before you can take from the group.
I am the group. Oh, sorry. That was Forge.
Anyway, regardless, I want to sell 7 sets of plate armor then.
Okay. It's always good to have a spare just in case somebody's gets broken.
Yeah, keep one for spares.
Actually, can Oriana wear a plate?
She has one.
She has. plate.
Okay. So how much is one set of plate armor is 1,500, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
But it will sell well. Let me see.
No, Eris is, he's opening an armor shop.
Yeah, really?
50% if you're lucky.
Are you going to, like, a store to sell it, or are you just pawning it off to, like, random soldiers?
Well, first I'm going to try to see if a store will take it. Well, actually, I'm going to see how much a soldier will pay for it.
Okay. You walk up to a random soldier?
Well, a well-off-looking soldier.
They're soldiers?
I mean, you see a few, but they already have, like, nice shiny plate armor.
Fine, I'll look for a middle-class soldier, then.
Yeah, you find a guy in, like, chainmail, and you walk up to him.
Hey, you want to buy some plate armor?
Spice? Yeah, I guess I could.
How much are you going
to have? Money-wise?
Yes, I'm selling plate armor.
Oh, well, it'd probably be best to sell it to the blacksmith in town.
That is true. However, then you gotta pay the blacksmith, who will probably charge you more than I will.
Well, that's probably true. I mean, how much are you selling it for?
Well,
it's pretty expensive in town right now because, you know, there's a war going on and they're trying to ration supplies.
That is true. Well, it's 1,500 to get it from a blacksmith, which is what it'll sell it to.
It's much more expensive than that.
Oh, what's the current value?
Well, I mean, if that's what you're willing to sell it for.
What's the current value?
Well, it's nearly double now.
Oh, really? Huh. I'm going to go talk to the blacksmith.
Okay.
If you will offer me more than 1,500, because that's best I'm going to get from the blacksmith.
I will say that's how much he's selling it for, not necessarily paying for it.
Well, you said it was worth double now.
Mm-hmm.
Which means it's worth 3,000.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, I mean, he might just give us the 750 for it. Anyway, regardless, I'm going to go see the blacksmith and see how much he offers.
What? You guys walk in, and you notice that this is the same blacksmith that you guys had seen before, and he seems to be just as busy as before, but he seems to have a few more soldiers actually in the shop and helping out. So are you dragging the chest in?
Yes, I bring the chest in.
Okay. It takes you some time because Oriana isn't helping. She's kind of just sitting quietly in the cart. You drag it in, and he'll say, seems like you got quite a haul there.
Yes, we have some plate armor, some javelins, and some great axes.
Oh, that's good. A good donation to the army.
Not a donation. My friends died to get this stuff. Not a donation.
I see. Not. All right. Well, I guess let me see what you have.
I show him the stuff.
Let's see. You have 7 plate armor?
Yes, that's what I'm showing him. I'm keeping a spare in case Oriana's breaks.
Okay. Make me do the math. And you said javelins? Are you selling all the javelins?
Yeah, neither of us uses javelins.
Okay. Do, 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 do. And then the great axe is...
$6,128 when you divide it out in half.
He'll say, I can give you 5,000 gold.
Can I roll a persuasion to try to get that higher?
You can talk to him to try to get it higher.
You sure I can't just roll persuasion?
You need to actually say the words.
Well, you know.
Make the roll.
Role play.
Yeah, I will. I
want to role play a game, damn it. Even if JD wants to skip everything.
I need to know how well I do before I model how I talk.
You need to what?
I need to know how well I do. Like, if I nat one, I'm not going to be like, well, you see, sir, I think you'll find. I'll be like, give me fucking 2 billion gold for it.
Fine, roll first and then act after. Takes all the fun out of it, but whatever.
Look, we both know that this is worth quite a bit more than what you're offering. Like, I think you could easily make a profit if you give me 7,000 gold.
Well,
wow.
That's quite a bit higher than what it's actually
at worth. This point, is it?
But the army is in need. The most I can do is 6,000.
I'll take 6,000.
So he'll start inventorying all the things that you hand him. And thank you for your business. And then you can see him, he kind of, like, he counts everything and gives you the gold, and then he just passes it on and starts working again.
Okay.
They seem ever busy here.
Yes. Okay, so we have one set of plate armor now. So, have we been assigned our new squad yet?
You have not. You guys were told to talk to Shell.
In which case, I guess we head to Shell.
Okay. Are you guys walking back and forth, or are you just taking the cart?
I imagine we're just taking the cart.
Okay. Yeah, and you get a few people who, they notice you guys, just because they recognize you from stories that have been told. You guys do manage to find Shell after some time. It does take you a little bit of time. And you can see her talking to different soldiers and whatnot. And she'll be like, oh, good, you guys are back from Hallgren. I hadn't heard the status of your mission yet, but I'm guessing it went well.
We are the only survivors. The rest are dead. We didn't take Hallgren.
How?
Awkward.
Way to sugarcoat that. Well,
I've already had to tell the story like once today.
Yeah. Well, I have you guys spoken to the High Council?
Yeah, that's who I told the story to already. They told us to come to you to get a new squad.
Yeah, we were starting to get concerned after. You know, it was 10 more days than expected that we hadn't heard from you guys, but now I guess we know why. The squad's tent is over here. We lost a few in the fight, but we have some new members. And you guys can see that your squad isn't quite made up of as many Dragonborn as it was before. There's a couple elves. You see a gnome. With a weird-looking creature next to him. Kind of reminds you of Forge a little bit, just because it's mechanical.
No.
My eagle's not there.
Oh, it's not?
The thing moves at 10 feet on the ground. It's up circling somewhere, waiting for me.
Well, I mean, you're just sitting down in the tent. I mean, you're not doing anything.
I'm tinkering.
Well, that, I mean, you're not actively on duty, is what I should say.
Is he a soldier?
Yes.
Kind debatable. Of.
You're a different kind of soldier.
He's like a shitty soldier?
No. He's not a frontline guy. But that's, you don't know that. Yeah, so she kind of, like, gingerly, like, welcomes you to the group and offers you guys, like, real food and whatnot. And you can tell, like, people keep looking at Oriana because she hasn't said anything. They're kind of perturbed by the situation, but hearing what you just said, they kind of understand.
I stay very close
also,
to
Oriana. I was playing with the ring that Zarek gave me, and the shadows have been activated, so I'm kind of shrouded.
Yeah, and she has this weird shadow, like, it's kind of like in one of those cartoons where it's this sad cloud following you around, but it's just shadow. And it's very, like, this army has a lot of magic users, so it's not completely crazy, but it's kind of unnerving, especially you being a drow. But they kind of... Yeah, they kind of just, nobody says anything, but they'll take, like, side glances or whatever, but nobody, like, brings it up or whatever. But yeah, you guys can sit down, and does Corix want to introduce himself?
Not really. He's a quiet, nerdy person. He's building a little fire starter. Yeah. He's not really paying attention.
Okay. You guys are sitting there for, you guys have started sitting down, kind of around the area where your squad is. And two individuals will walk up. The dwarven gentleman that you saw before, and a hooded figure. And Alan can introduce himself now, too. Basically, Alan and JD, I can't remember your name. You guys were sent... I know. You were sent, after questioning some things, you found out the status of Hallgren, and you were sent down to the group that came back, and you're very interested in going with them. And he did mention that you guys, they would probably need some help going back up there and recovering the situation. Same goes with Thorgrim. You were interested in going up to Hallgren with them, so you kind of,
No shit.
Yeah, you kind of found your way to them and pretty much offered to go with, or you're going to offer. But you guys find those two with their squad to introduce yourselves to them.
Wait, so I walk
Hello.
In?
Yeah, they're just sitting outside their squad's tent at, like, a fire.
Eros is playing a song on his flute.
And Alan's character's there, also?
Yes, he came with you. And you guys kind of met in the barracks.
Okay.
Both of you kind of outsiders from the actual army, but interested in the situation.
Eros invents the blues as a musical.
Blues.
Well, you'll see a dwarf walk over to you guys, who may or may not be wearing plate armor at the moment.
Oh my god.
He's got gray hair and a long gray beard. And he's going to say, yes, you, all of you, listen. I've been, I've been authorized to take some of you with me to Hallgren. So you, and also you. You're coming with me.
You know we can't see you when you point, right?
What?
Who do you point to?
points to the them. So Oriana just points, just kind of at random, just picks all of these people out.
Yeah. And you like point to Quirks, and he's kind of like, what? He has no idea what's going
That's right,
on. He
you,
doesn't
gnome.
Even.
What? Why do you need me?
Well, I don't know. What are you doing there? Looks like you're doing something important.
Just making some stuff.
And I'll tell you now, nothing's more important than getting to Holgrun right now. So pack up your shit.
Back up there.
Shell kind of interjects. She's like, well, they just got back. I think they need the night before they go back into that situation.
Who the hell are you?
Going back.
I'm their commanding officer.
I can polymorph him into, like, a toad, if you want. I think it'll be rather funny.
That's a little unnecessary. It would be seen as an offense.
I won't step on him or anything.
Well, I understand that you guys are grieving, but they did have orders, obviously. And she kind of looks at you, and your orders were those. And Thorgrim, you were given a scroll by the commander.
You two, drow, elf.
God.
Racist.
It was your friends that died. Don't you want to get back and avenge them?
Not particularly. That would mean us dying, probably. Yeah.
That's not the right attitude.
You realize those things literally killed a warforged by poking it, right?
Well, I assume that you went in unprepared.
We don't have any idea what they are.
But now you know what you're up against.
No, we don't.
But leave that to me, I can find out.
It was made of darkness and it killed things by poking them. What you got?
You can find out. I knew he looked good. He's good. He's on the team.
Quirks and Thorgrim have an instant bond.
Nothing. Well, I'm just interested in these things that can kill Warforged.
Oh.
I don't know how they did it, I just know they did.
He's going to look at Alan's character.
Yeah, it is great.
And he's going to say, hey, you there, what's your story?
My name is Born. Nice to meet you.
That's it.
I'm not from around here. I'm from the south. I came to Newborn to try to get into the Krendorian army, and here I am. I look forward to working with you. That is all.
I like your enthusiasm. You're coming too. All right, let's go.
What's your rank?
Who are you asking that?
I am asking that to the annoying bossy dwarf.
I don't have a rank. I'm not in the military.
Then, by what authority do you command us to come with you?
I was given authorization.
Let me see that authorization.
You hand him for the scroll.
Sure.
Yeah, on the... Go ahead.
I'm gonna try to figure out if it's faked.
Okay.
Would that be insight, or...?
It would insight. Be...
Investigation, or
investigation?
Investigation, I think, yeah.
They're both terrible.
Yeah.
14, is it fake?
I mean, it seems it had the wax seal from the commander. You've seen similar scrolls that Shell's been given, so it seems legit.
I hand it back, and I'm like, I'm watching you.
That's the spirit. All right. Let's go.
But did you not just hear me? They just got back. I don't think they're ready to leave right this second.
Oriana's going to look right at Thorgrim, and she's going to say, no.
First word.
No.
Yep.
What do you mean, no? Gotta save my people.
They're dead.
Not today.
Alright, Thorgrim storms off.
Well, there are any survivors right. In the wherever you came from?
What?
I'm sorry, repeat that. I have no idea what you just said.
Sorry, my accent is a little thick. Were there any survivors in wherever you came from?
Just us.
I point to Eros and myself.
That's it?
I nod.
Oh. That's bad.
I nod again.
As I keep working on stuff.
These two probably need the night before they head out to another mission. Or rather, the same mission. But you guys
can't. What time is it right now?
It would be probably almost getting into the evening. Like, the sun hasn't set quite yet, but it's about to.
Hey,
Mr.
Man.
What?
Can you make my bow better?
Potentially. I'll have to take a look at it, but if we're not leaving tonight, I have to go scouting.
Scouting?
Yep.
Yeah.
Then Corks does a whistle, and a giant metal bird lands next to him. He hops on it and flies off.
It's taking everything in me not to turn into a giant eagle and follow him.
What? A metallic eagle, like, swooped you up and like,
yeah,
carried you off?
Oh my god.
Very worried, and I pull out my hand crossbow, and I take him.
Yeah, I'm going to shoot my longbow.
Shell will kind of put her hands up like, hey guys, he's a soldier. They assigned scouts to different squadrons. Just
a giant metal bird is trying to eat that gnome.
Whoa. He built that thing. It's very
it literally landed. I hopped on its back and
I thought it just like swooped down and
it's like, god damn, how does this not happen to gnomes all the time?
Are giant eagles known to swoop down and pick up gnomes and just carry them off?
Oh, that's awful. They would go after much better. That's why they live underground, is so they don't get swooped up by giant flying things.
Yep.
We're pretty much the meerkats of the world.
Oh my gosh. I'm gonna stand up and walk over to Shell. I'm gonna look at her. And I'm just going to say, temple?
It's down that road there.
And then I'm going to head in that direction.
Okay. And Shell will kind of look at Eros like, maybe she shouldn't be alone.
Yeah, I'm going to go with her. And he will.
Oh.
And then he's by himself.
Who's by himself?
You.
Where'd Thorgrim go?
He left a long time ago.
Yeah,
he was mad that I said no and left.
Yeah.
He's having
it just
a tantrum.
Broke him.
Aw. I was really looking forward to meeting my team.
You met them all.
Yeah, you did. You met all of us.
And they seem like such fun people.
Yeah.
They all literally walked away. Alright. Is there anything specific you want to do at the... Well, it's more of like a church. This isn't a huge town. It's a nicer church. You can see that some of it has been damaged. And you guys kind of see the damage all around town. But is there anything specific you want to do there?
Are there any... So is it just like a... kind of a non-denominational church of sorts.
Yeah,
there's two specific deities.
No, they're separate. At the front, you can see that there are, like, mini statues depicting the different deities and kind of little alcoves at the top. So you can kind of tell that it's just the main ones that generally everybody would pray to.
Okay, I'm gonna head to, like, the back, I guess, of the church, and I'm just gonna sit for a second. I'm gonna turn the ring off.
Okay.
So I'm not, like, in a church with shadows all around me. That'd be kind of weird.
Yeah. A dark figure walks in.
She's clearly possessed by a demon.
Arrow also sits, like, on the pew right behind her.
Okay.
So I'm gonna kind of go there. I know that he's behind me, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah. You sense that he's been following you.
Actually, I'm
Oh, God.
Okay.
I'm joking.
Not creepy.
I'm joking. I'm not stalking my girlfriend.
You can if you want to. I don't care at this point. I'm so good. No. All right. So I'm going to kind of go in, and I'm just going to I'm going to sit. I'm going to stare. Consciously, I'm just going to reach out a little bit and see if I can feel Lilia anywhere.
Okay.
Should I do some kind of religion check? Or...
Sure.
To see if I can feel my deity nearby. Maybe not my deity anymore. We'll see. And probably not.
Let me find my deity sheet. Oh, God.
You have a deity sheet?
I have so many pieces of paper.
Eros is just going to pray to no one in particular, asking why the fuck, man, thought we were cool. Thought things were supposed to turn out well. But the good guys, why did all my friends die? He also fails. Eros would love to set fire.
So good at this. Oh, no.
Religion has failed us. We're becoming atheists now.
Yeah. Oriana, you feel this coldness in you. For the first time in your life, you don't feel the happiness and joy that you've always sensed while in a church, just because there's been so much death in the last few weeks, starting with, you know, your mentor and now three friends that you considered close, and one of them you've even brought back before, and you really start questioning the purpose of your role, basically, and you don't get any signs or anything like that from your deity, per se. But you start questioning your religion more than you have ever really done before, because you've been so sure before of everything.
Okay. I don't feel anything this time, right? Usually I feel pretty good in places like this.
Yeah, for the first time, this is the first time you've been in a church and you feel like it's an alien place, not somewhere that you're comfortable.
So I'm gonna get up and I'm gonna walk out really quickly. And do we know where the barracks are here? Do we know where we're staying?
Yeah, you guys are staying in that tent with the squad. Or you can get a room at the inn. It's really up to you.
We have
okay, I'm going to go to neither of those places.
Okay.
I'm going to go toward like a forest area.
Okay.
And kind of find myself a clearing.
Eros follows. Eros is not leaving her alone. All he needs is for like a bandit to cut off her head.
Oh god.
I think Oriana can handle herself.
Yeah, well I thought Forge could handle himself.
Okay.
And clearly I can't get away from him, so I'm just gonna keep going and pretend like he's not there. So do I find like a nice little clearing in this forest area?
Yeah, it's not as cold as it's been. There's been warmer weather down here. Not as cold as it was up in the north. There's still light snow on the ground, but yeah, you'll find a clearing in the middle of the forest there, where there's just like a opening.
That's so creepy. Okay, so I'm gonna get to my little clearing, I'm gonna say that I was probably walking pretty hastily because I'm feeling very upset that I don't feel the same way that I did when I was in the temple before. And I'm just gonna kind of, I'm gonna stop in this clearing. What time of day is it right now?
The sun is setting. Right about now.
The sun's setting. Okay. I'm gonna come into this clearing. And I'm just gonna scream like as loud as I possibly can.
Okay.
And then kind of drop and just cry.
Eros is gonna stay nearby but not touch her.
Okay. So you kind of just fall to the ground, you know, upset. Hold on.
I hear typing.
Secret.
Secret.
Eros kind of just raised himself to sit on the outskirts of your clearing for a little bit. And you cry. You can feel yourself getting kind of cold as, you know, the sun starts to set. But it doesn't seem to bother you.
Does she just sleep in the clearing?
I don't know. It's up to her. Just shortly after you scream, you do see a bird above you. And it seems like a rather large bird. Kind of reminds you of the one that, the time that Eros became a bird.
You mean the time that all of our friends died?
Oh, God. I love how you say that every time.
She's just, she'll kind of keep her eyes on the bird and curl up into a ball on the ground.
Is it a metal bird?
You can't tell.
Is she in the field?
Eros is going to do some target practice.
No, she's in the field in the forest around the town.
Oh, okay.
So, Corks, you can do whatever you want.
Yeah, target practice.
Are you going to shoot at the bird?
Yeah, Eros is just generally speaking mad at the world right now, so yes, he's going to shoot at the bird.
Oh my gosh, you're going to kill something in front of her?
How far is it? I'm like up a couple thousand feet, bub.
Wait, what?
Yeah, so Eros shoots his arrow in that general direction, but it falls short.
Unless he has a breathing mask, he's not up a couple thousand feet.
You don't know what I have.
I'm saying, like, you know, like Goliaths are special because they can be 2,000 feet in the air. Because of mountains.
Anyway, so you shoot at him, and it kind of falls short. You feel like you probably don't have as much strength as you thought you did.
I just glare at the bird and go, fucking bird.
You see a small head pop up from behind one of the shoulder, and you can feel a glare from way up there looking at you.
So, and this little gnome hand flipping you off.
So, Quirks, you're in the air and you hear this scream, and then you get shot at by a bow. Do you want to investigate further, or what are you doing?
Well, as soon as I heard the scream, I pulled down my Eyes of the Eagle to scout out and see what was going on.
You see a woman curled up in the middle of the forest.
There's a half-elf aiming a bow at you.
And he's kind of hiding in the trees, which seems suspicious.
Well, I kind of remember them.
Yeah, you would recognize Oriana.
Yeah.
There aren't many drow around,
How does she look?
She does not look well. She is curled up on a ball on the ground, and you can kind of see her shivering. She looks rather distraught.
Bork then kind of sighs to himself and muttering, and has Roderick, his bird, taken him for a landing.
Okay. Sirius, the bird that you shot at, actually lands, and it's the one that you saw before that picked up the gnome.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know it was your bird.
I walk towards Oriana. Awkwardly.
Go ahead.
She's still sobbing.
Yeah.
So he's just kind of holding one of his arms, kind of looking awkward at her, and be like, are you okay?
No response.
That's Oriana. Don't touch her.
You're gonna poke her?
I poke her with my foot a little bit.
I'll curl up even more.
I'm not sure if I should shoot him or explain.
I'm surprised you haven't come closer yet, Eros, honestly.
At this point, I do come closer. My bow is trained on him. Should probably leave her alone.
My bird is watching you.
Good for your bird. I'll just use heat metal on it.
Why always fight? Every game.
Every single game.
He's kicking my girlfriend.
I did not kick her. I'm a 3-foot gnome that's nudging her with a foot.
But Eros would see it as kicking. Yeah, sure.
At this point, anyone who touches her deserves death.
Oh, God.
God. I'm sure Oriana would do so well with that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You see, Oriana's reaction was to close down. Eros' reaction is no one will ever hurt Oriana again.
Until you hurt her.
Oh, God!
And Discord's like, well, I guess we're gonna be, working together. So, probably, I don't know, try to get in a better headspace for tomorrow?
We just watched our friends die, like, 10 days ago in front of us, and we were useless. Their bodies are currently in an ancient dwarven city or something, surrounded by the creatures that killed them. I don't think there is much of a better headspace either of us could be in.
Bork six notes him and is still looking at Oriana. Begin to slow down like a lizard?
No, like the tears are getting less frequent. Like she's not sobbing as hard as she was.
Eros is gonna walk over and like drape a blanket over her.
Where do you get a blanket?
Quirk's kind of rolls his eyes. He'll put his fire starter down right by her, snap it on, and a little campfire starts.
Okay.
She's just gonna, she'll look up at him now and just kind of send him some silent gratitude that she's still not speaking to him.
Yeah, he doesn't say anything. He just stares at the fire, and he'll get back to, he'll start tinkering some more on stuff.
Okay. So Quirks makes you guys a fire and starts, like, silently messing with stuff in his bag and pulls some stuff out. Eros, is there anything else you want to do?
Eros is just going to start, like, composing a song, basically.
Okay.
What?
Hey, he's doing something on purpose, okay?
Okay.
This isn't just something random.
Rolls his eyes and gets back to working.
So are you guys staying the night there?
Yeah, I'm just going to fall asleep.
Okay.
I'm not.
Yeah, I kind of figured. Thorgrim and Bjorn, are you guys doing anything in town for the night?
Nope, not really.
Okay.
Nope, he's camping outside of town, just staring at the fire, thinking about his poor wife and children who these people are refusing to help him save.
They don't know that. You didn't say that.
No, you just went like, is there survivors? You should come help me.
It's your words. Alright. So you guys spend your night in various places. And in the morning...
Can I do one thing before morning?
Yeah. That's fine.
I'm assuming, because I'm an artificer and good at tinkering, can I make a tiny little, like, toy? I could do it when I was thinking about being a rock gnome, but I'm a forest gnome, so I don't know if I can now.
I don't know. Let me look. Pretty sure you... Are you wanting it to do anything, or just, like...
No.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine.
Alright, can I make a tiny little, pretty much a wind-up mechanical dog that's just, like, tiny by my hand, like, by my hand size?
Yeah.
I'll put it next to Oriana, wind it up, and it starts walking around. I'll hop on my bird and fly away.
Okay. That's Quirks' way of solacing people. Alright, so you guys, get up in the morning,
Yeah.
And you guys are gonna, Thorin and Bjorn, you guys head back to the tent where you had met the others. And Quirks is there. Is Oriana and Eris going to show back up?
Gonna try to not show back up? Oriana, are we gonna become deserters? Because, like,
no, we're not. So when Oriana wakes up this morning, she'll just kind of sit up. And is there actually a blanket placed on her, or no? It was just a fire, right?
Right.
Well, I mean, there's some weird robot thing wandering around her head.
We'll say that Eros had gotten you a blanket and brought it back, so. Okay. And yes, there is a a small wind-up toy. It's stopped now, but there's a small wind-up toy next to you.
Okay. So I'll sit up, fold the blanket, pick up the toy, walk over to Eros. She's is he awake? Are you awake?
Probably. Yeah.
Probably.
Well, how early is up with a like, scream?
Yeah, I mean, that was several times in the night.
Yeah, I have lots of nightmares now.
That's going to be annoying.
Yeah. Like,
no one gets long rests anymore.
Sorry. My bad, friends. I didn't realize. Just everyone died. No. Okay, anyways, I'm going to go over to Eros. And, are you still sitting on the ground? Are you standing up?
I'm sitting on the ground.
She's gonna, she'll just take two fingers and, kind of brush his cheek with the backside of them, and then she'll start to walk back toward the tent.
Now he will follow her.
Alright. You guys are just gonna leave the fire?
Well, I mean, how long does that fire last?
I don't know.
Eros just wants to see the world burn. He doesn't put it out.
It's just like a tiny flame. Like,
yeah, I was a joke. It's fine. Only you.
We no longer care about preventing forest fires.
Who cares? It's Stooka.
Exactly.
You guys head back to camp, and you see that the other three are already there, and they're kind of preparing to leave. Are you guys going to take your cart with you? I'm assuming you will.
Yes.
So Bjorn and Quirx and Thorgrim, you guys see Eros and Orianna start packing up a cart, which seems odd because many soldiers don't get carts.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good luck. Oh, you have a cart.
Yes, it's a good cart.
All right, Thorgrim's gonna go sit in the driver's seat.
Oh, okay.
Do you know how to drive a cart?
Of course I do.
God. Okay.
It's really hard not to slip back into Forge voice. It's impossible, really, and I apologize.
It's not you doing it, it's just everybody hearing it. Eros and Orianna hearing it as Forge, because it's so similar.
Yeah.
Yes, I know how to drive a cart.
I don't suppose Warforged are count as beasts.
Nope.
No.
Because I could have just polymorphed him into a Warforged.
They're constructs.
A minor illusion. We had Zarek.
I have minor illusion.
For disguise self, just put some friggin' metal on yourself. Done.
Oh god. I hop on my bird.
Okay.
And it's just flying above the cart. And I poke my head over and say, "Everyone, this is Roderick. Roderick, say hello." And it caws.
And it kind of reminds you guys of Eris and Orion, and it kind of reminds you of when Frostfire would follow the cart through the air.
Stop that! Why are you trying to like dig it in? Like, what's?
Because
you're an awful person.
Can we paint it black?
No story is good unless it has sad parts. What's wrong with you?
All right, hey, Cork, can we paint it black?
You touch my bird, he has permission to attack you.
I'm pretty sure I can take it, but you didn't answer my question.
I fly up higher.
Orianna, will give you back your toy. She knows it's not Eros's, but, I mean, before we left, she would have handed it to you.
I just look at it and say, "Nope, that's for you."
She's like, "I don't want it."
I don't know what to do with this.
Is everyone
so
in
I guess she'll just kind of hold it and sit.
Yes, ride! As soon as everyone gets on, we're like,
yeah, exactly. As soon as everyone gets on, like, boom, those horses are like full speed.
Wow, you guys are so weird. You guys were yelling at James for not RPing stuff, and now you're trying to speed up everybody's RP.
Yeah.
Bunch of hypocrites, I tell you.
No, I'm just saying. That,
No, that's...
It's his character.
I know. Trust me,
his RPing
I know.
Is very low.
Yeah, so you guys pile into the car except for Cork, so he decides to fly above it. You guys will spend the next 10 days moving up to Hallgren.
The closer we get, the more uncomfortable Oriana is. She's like moving around a lot, fidgeting, and seems to be having more nightmares.
Hera spends a lot of time writing in a book.
Yeah, and you guys noticed that Oriana attempts to wake up a lot in the middle of the night, loudly.
Oriana and Eros have their own tent. So when this happens, Eros will very quickly, like, attempt to soothe her.
After, like, the first two nights, Quarks will move away from camp.
All right.
Sorry that my sadness is such an inconvenience to you.
I have a charisma of 7. You don't give a care.
That's okay.
He doesn't have them social skills. Okay. Is there anything special you guys want to do over those 10 days? I'm guessing not.
Eros is gonna, you know, basically take everyone's measure and learn how they're gonna be useful.
Okay. You guys don't get into any fights, so it's hard to tell, what anybody's gonna be capable of.
He's gonna go up to him and be like, what are you good for?
Oh.
He has a charisma score of 18, he just doesn't care.
Okay.
So, first he'll walk up to the dwarf, who seems to be the one heading this expedition. What are your skills?
Shady!
Huh? What?
What are your skills?
My skills?
Yes, what are you good at?
It'd be easier to answer, what am I not good at? Yes. Mm-hmm.
So what are...
Oh god. I'm gonna love this character.
Oh, what am I not good at? Well, I'm not very good with the bow. That's it.
So you're a warrior then? Are you magical? What do you do? How are you useful in a fight?
Oh yes, much warrior, many magics. Yes, indeed.
So you know magic?
Many, many magics. Yes. And he continues, like, he's not, he's like half paying attention to you as he's like driving his cart full speed, and then he just continues like to mutter to himself something.
Yeah, you guys notice that he talks a lot under his breath.
Can I attempt to incite him to, for insanity?
Sure.
Yeah.
Got Alzheimer's. Dementia.
Yeah, he is pretty old.
Yeah, you guys definitely notice that he's much older than the normal, like, soldier would be.
Is a 9 high enough to figure out this guy's fucking insane?
No.
No, you just assume that he's older. He's an older gentleman. I don't know why I keep saying that, but it's fun.
Does he look older even for a dwarf?
Super old.
Yeah, he has white hair, You can explain your appearance. I'll have to do that.
He has a face like a catcher's mitt. Lots of creases.
I was like, what does that mean? Okay, you're talking
it's old, leathery, lots of creases.
Mm-hmm.
talking to D&D nerds, not baseball team.
He looks like Sean Connery.
Okay. Does he sound like Sean Connery?
If I can get it to work, maybe. Maybe. No, not really. That was Forge again.
I'm Sean Connery.
Anyway.
Just roll your R's.
Yeah.
Anyway. Yes, and what about you? What do you do?
I'm a bard.
Oh, that's nice. Play me a little song.
I actually will start to play a song. It doesn't have any lyrics yet.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a little something I'm working on. And he seems very sad as he plays this. It's a work in progress.
I've heard better. I've heard worse.
It is actually, something I'm just building or putting together now. I'll let you hear it when it's done.
Mush!
Mush! You're talking to horses!
Whatever humans say, I don't know.
What did he say to horse? Yeah, that's it. Yep, that's it.
So, next I'll approach Bjorn.
Hi.
Hi, I just wanted to get a feel for everyone's combat capabilities.
I am capable.
What are you?
Capable.
Are you a caster?
Do you mean... No spells.
Oh, well, what do you use?
Dagger and small bow.
Okay. So you're sort of like a ranged fighter?
If I have to, yes. I can fight from range.
I'm a bard. Decent with spells or a bow, so, you know.
Good to know.
He nods a bit and says, this is much, much more straightforward than the answers I got from that dwarf.
I look over at the dwarf. I see.
What's the name of the, can you type into chat the name of the place where Forge and everyone died? I'm writing a song.
Ogun?
Yes.
Not Helgen.
Olgrim.
Yeah.
Helgen it is.
I always call it Helgen. It's even named Helgen on the stupid map, but, you know, it's not that. Oh, gosh. Alright. Anything else during this trip?
I'm pretty sure I know what Korix does. He builds stuff. So, I'm good.
Music. Did it. Alright, so you guys arrived back at Holgrin. It's pretty much the same scene as you saw before. You see nothing outside, but there are still, Luffy there. There are still, corpses around. They're definitely more decayed now. What do you guys want to do?
Oh, and Thorgrim now has plate mail. You no longer have plate mail.
He talked to you about it.
Where's my bird?
Crap, I forgot about that. You can't help bird!
Oh, I'm assuming, kind of like on the way, also, that they probably would have explained to the new people kind of, you know, what happened basically last time, you know what I mean? Or at least Eros probably would have.
Yeah.
Just so that they knew, you know, like, what they were heading to.
Okay. It was just like, we're all gonna die.
Also, when we get the day that we get within this distance, Corx will actually approach the group and be like, alright, who's here more of the front line variety of person?
No, we're not Dorgans. I can see.
So you should be able to.
I can be front line in theory, but I prefer ranged.
Okay, so not you. You. And he points to the dwarf. You frontline?
Yes.
Alright. He'll then walk up to him and hand him a small glass bead. And he says, if you get into trouble, break this.
What does it do?
It should temporarily boost your defenses by a bit.
Yes. Excellent. Thank you.
Then I point to Bjorn and be like, you.
Yes?
Are you frontline?
50-50.
Good enough. And I'll hand him the same identical glass bead. And then I go to Orion and be like, you.
She's sort of midline.
She's wearing heavy plate armor, I mean.
Yeah, so he'll take that and be like, alright, here. And he'll more gingerly hand her another glass bead.
Okay.
You get into trouble, break it.
Break it?
Yes, there's a spell in there that can help you guys, but it will take up concentration, so take that into account.
For the character. Okay. Thorgrim, the first thing you notice is that the city is wholly the same, but you can tell that there's been battle here, and you see fallen dwarves around. Even, you know, it looks like some of them are trying to escape. But the city itself seems to be intact, although it's quieter than you've ever heard it before.
Eros is going to, before we head in, give everyone else a point of inspiration. And he's going to do this with a song that he's been writing over the last week.
Ooh, good.
Into the dungeon dark and deep, the day that interrupts our sleep. The darkness danced and shadows leaped in the ancient dwarven keep. The epic duel beneath the stone. To reclaim the ancient throne, the day was grim in old Holgrim, where bones now lay and spirits play. Back to the old stone lands, the party now readies, blades in hands, ready to avenge their friends. The lands were lost, soon to be captured for eternity. For glory or their friends' cold bones, each charges in for reasons their own. And he will roll performance to see how well he delivers his song.
Okay.
Yeah. That just happened.
Yeah, I wrote a song. I'm not good at that.
It is uncomfortable.
It's very depressing.
Well, he's a bard that just had all of his friends die. Of course he's writing depressing music.
No, I like it.
So, going in, does he, are these corpses, recognizable?
Can I have advantage because of the quality of song?
Oh, you can roll. You will not have advantage on every roll. Thorgrim would not be able to recognize them. I mean, these bodies have been here for, you know, almost a month.
Okay.
Pretty much a month now, so... it's a pretty vile smell, by the way.
Can Koryx, when people start approaching, he gestures for them to stop. He pops on his goggles, and so he can see stuff super, super well. Can he try and look at what Orianna and Eros were describing as shadow creatures? Does he see anything super in there?
You move out to the entrance, which, Thorim, you notice that the large doors that used to be here on the entrance are gone. You look down the hallway, you don't see any kind of movement or anything. You just see more corpses pretty much lining the hallway. But you don't
see... Do I recognize any of the corpses?
I mean, from what you can tell, it's the same... It doesn't look like anything's moved, except for what you guys had moved whenever you were last here.
I'm asking if I see the bodies of my friends.
Immediately, no.
Okay.
But they didn't die at
the end. Bodies, because I see super fire.
You see a bunch. Quirks doesn't know them.
I will ask if he sees a Warforged.
Let me see if you would see that. I don't think you can see that.
Well,
far.
With my Eyes of the Eagle on, I have advantage on perception. I can make out stuff very detailed.
It would be like 200 feet away, so I don't think so.
It might actually be like a mile. I'm not sure.
Yeah. Look. I posted what it says about him.
Oh, there you are.
Extremely distant.
Okay, so I guess make a perception check. Just to kind of see if you can see, just a Warforged, I guess.
16.
You think you see one? I mean, everybody, there are several, corpses here that look like they were in armor, so you think you see one, but it's pretty far away, pretty far into the city, and we're actually going to take a break here.
Does Bjorn really only have a dagger for a melee weapon?
Yes.
I'm going to offer him a short sword.
He's going to turn it down. Well, thanks.
Okay, then. That one's gonna die first, I say as I walk away.
Yes. Are you all coming?
Hold on.
So I rolled a 27 stealth, so I'm moving up.
I am casting Death Ward on Eros.
Oh.
Not really going to help if the strength is zero, but okay.
No, it will, because it says if the spell is still in effect when the target is subjected to an effect that would kill it instantaneously without dealing damage, that effect is instead negated against the target and the spell ends.
Oh.
So this can protect him from getting his last piece of strength zapped from his body.
How well lit is this place?
Kills.
One second. Sorry, guys. There are sconces in the wall that light everything. It's still pretty well lit, which is kind of wrong in a sense, just because there is so much death here, and there's just this overwhelming smell of decay and death here. But it is all really well lit, so you get to see everything in detail. The blood on the floor is coagulated in like this really thick, sticky, hard to walk in mess. So you guys kind of avoid that as you walk through.
Okay, I look behind and I like motion the party to come forward.
Okay.
Oh, we would have warned them that they appear suddenly out of nowhere. on the ride.
Yes, stay together. Yes.
Jordan is already gone.
I would like to cast Spirit Guardians. Mm-hmm. And we're walking in.
Can that move?
What?
It goes with me. It's a 15-foot radius around myself.
It follows her.
And remember, everyone has a point of inspiration. You can add it to your attack roll, your damage, or your AC, or anything else you can normally inspiration.
Everyone has inspiration? What?
Yeah, I gave everyone inspiration with my very sad song.
Oh.
It's a very sad inspiration.
Everyone?
Yeah,
it actually
all
gives
my
you
points of inspiration.
Okay.
You actually
just five of us. You have five.
Well, I can't give myself inspiration.
Yeah.
Oh, gotcha. Four.
You have to be like level like 10 or something. I don't know, something really high.
Yeah. All right. Well, stay together.
Jordan is already gone.
Get Frank's dead in the head.
Just kidding.
What's that?
That is a bull.
How high is the ceiling?
I think last time we said it was like 20 feet high. Pretty tall ceilings for, you know, dwarves.
What is this room?
It just seems to be a storeroom.
This is a storeroom.
Can I be riding my bird, Kelsey?
Yeah, that's fine.
We use this room to store various things. Yes.
Thorgrim, you will know that these beginning rooms are kind of where outsiders would trade with the city. And it's kind of just one of those places where they stored goods to trade.
Looks eerily empty.
Can I do a perception check trying to see if there's anything hiding in shadows or anywhere?
Yeah, definitely.
20.
You don't see anything or hear anything. It's really quiet here. Eerily so.
Okay, I'm gonna pull out my thunder sling and have it ready as I have my bird fly me around looking.
Okay. I'm not really sure if there's anything I can prepare other than, you know, turning into a giant eagle, grabbing Oriana and flying away, which I'm not going to do yet.
Right about the time that you guys get Oriana and Eris, where you get there, you do see Zarek's body laying amongst the others. It's obviously fresher than the others.
Can you ping its location?
Yeah, it's about right there.
Okay. Are there any items around him, like, say, a staff?
There are.
I'm gonna, you know, I don't want to say loot him.
But you mean it.
I'm going to search him for useful items that we can use to avenge him.
Is this one of your allies?
Yes, his name was Zarek.
Help me pick him up and move him outside, into the cart.
Yes, I will help him with that.
Okay.
And I will, on the way back, I will describe the other allies. Yeah, so...
So I won't drag my fucking thing all the way to the cart, but let's say we, like, take, I don't know, 10 minutes to move the body to the cart.
Yeah.
Can I see the body that he was describing now?
Yeah, you would be, Asmir would be hard to see, but you're starting to see, you do see the Warforged up ahead, and it's more towards the middle area, like the Warforged is here, so... you guys can start moving that way. Do you want to point him out?
Thorgrim, do you recognize anything around here? Anybody? Any familiar?
I recognize everything.
I mean, are there people here that you know? Do you want to maybe move some of the deceased out for a proper burial?
I think we'll do that after we discover what's going on.
Apparently people died here and it gets dangerous, so I think it's better to move people out just in case, you know, shit hits the fan.
Right now?
Give me one second.
It would be further in.
Okay.
Just so you know. Yep. Thorgrim,
there's time for that later. There.
Thorgrim, you will know that this first area is the market, kind of like the outsider's market. And there are a few people that live up front, but a lot of people live towards the back.
There may be survivors yet, deeper in, and we need to rescue them. Time is of the essence.
Can... little gnome.
What?
Little Corks, was it?
Yeah?
Could you buy... I've heard tales of spellcasters making people invisible. Could you by chance do that? Could you turn me invisible?
No. Maybe once I get down the road a little bit, but currently I'm more geared towards other stuff.
What about you there, Eros?
You want to be turned invisible,
I want to go scout ahead.
I could turn you into a bug.
I'm very sneaky. I just need...
I can't turn things invisible. I'm more lighting
fine.
Stuff on fire.
And Bjorn moves ahead. Do I see the bodies?
Yeah. You do find the Warforged right in front of you there.
We'll make Gloriana set of plate.
Where's Asmir?
Asmir is a few feet away from him. You can kind of tell that, well, you don't know him, but it looks like the an Elven Ranger was trying to move towards Forge and fell before he could make it.
Is the ceiling any higher in here?
Mm-mm. It's all pretty, for a ceiling, it's all pretty tall in here, especially
okay.
For, you know, a shorter race. Everything seems to be overly large, but it's all pretty much 20 feet high. Where you go.
Okay.
Are these them?
Liana, does she see them yet?
Yeah.
And they're, like, in this general vicinity?
Yeah, Forge is right in front of Bjorn, and then, you know, 10 feet away from that is, Asmir. Eros.
Yeah, Eros. Eros is dead now.
He just collapses next to Orion.
Help me take the bodies back to the cart.
Orianna hasn't seen their bodies yet until this
That's
point,
not.
And
the
she...
The only one that you guys saw fall was Zarek.
Zarek, yeah. So she's going to kind of run forward and push past the two of them.
Oh, God.
And she's just going to kind of drop next to Forge's body, and she's... not being quiet about this at all. Like, she's full on, like, sobbing very loudly.
Okay.
And just kind of hugging his body.
I still have my... I'm ready to attack if anything pops up.
Mark, control her. Just gonna reveal our presence.
Control her.
Control your woman.
Yeah, exactly. I would love
Actually,
to see
you,
Eros.
You guys
try.
Don't know that Eros and Orion are together.
Nope.
Well, we kind of figured when you guys came out of the same tent.
Yeah, I
they
mean...
They could be siblings.
Yeah.
I'll leave that up to you. I'll leave that up to the characters to decide that on whether or not they just think they're close friends. But
or
anyway.
Or it's fooled.
Program, help me. Move one of you. Who are you grabbing onto? Forge?
Yeah, I have Forge.
I'll grab onto Asmir and just... I'll grab his legs and you grab his hands and we'll take him to the cart.
And these are your fallen companions.
Yes, two of them. I think...
Yes?
There isn't really much I could do to quiet her as you requested, unfortunately. She was particularly good friends with Forge. And I will gesture to the Warforged.
Do you by chance have a silence spell?
We're not even gonna
cast it in the zone so we don't, you know.
No, I don't have silence.
Worst part ever.
How about making music, not making quiet?
Alright, well, I will assist in moving your fallen comrade.
So we take Asmir's body. How long does it take us to get it to the cart?
That just takes you guys another 10 minutes.
Okay, we'll come back for Forge. Are you still, like, grabbing onto him?
When she sees you guys are going to take him outside, she'll let go.
Okay, I look back and I tell you two to grab the body.
They carry him down the hall. His face just kind of bounces off the wall a couple times.
Forge's body is the only one that's perfectly preserved. There's no sign of decay, which you kind of figured would happen. But it is kind of shocking seeing Forge there, because it looks like he's just laying there. It doesn't look any different than any other day.
It's not good. It's not good. It's unsettling. Yeah.
Sad stuff is fun.
So, I guess we load him in the cart as well.
Okay.
We'll make our way onto some plate armor out of him. Don't worry, it'll be fine.
Oh god, that's creepy.
I would never.
I actually could do that.
Don't touch him.
Quark seems very interested in the Warforged.
Yeah. Because
he's never
my bird.
He's never seen a dead one, per se.
I'm just looking at him very closely, but also keeping an eye out, because I'm like 15 feet up on my bird.
Okay, we come back. We took care of the bodies.
Yeah.
Anything else that we need to be aware of in this room?
No, this just looks like the central market. Thorgrim, you'll know that this is kind of the main source of outside business in this town. A lot of more extensive shops were here. Specialty item shops, kind of.
Right. So, with that taken care of, what are we, what's the mission here?
Well, we need to go deeper in. There may be survivors, as I said. So we
can
continue.
Damn, we're going to go deeper.
Are these pillars, I guess?
Pillars. Yeah, they're pillars, yeah.
Gotcha.
Those are pillars.
Are these chests or bales of hay?
Barrels?
What? Oh, those are like, they're like barrels. I don't know.
Is it full of anything?
I see my blood.
You kind of bend down to check it, and then you smell the rotting food inside of it.
I was hoping for dwarven ale.
So Thorgrim, you will know that to this exit is where the bar/brewery is, and the water source for Hallgren.
Yes, I know that well.
Yes, and then you will know that this way is towards the central square, and then onward to like the housing parts of the town.
Which way?
This way.
Okay.
And then you will know this way is to the forge, and the blacksmithing section, which is a very large section of town.
Hey, Kelsey.
Huh?
With my character being very particular about looking everywhere, would he notice said thing on the right?
Right? Dang it. I don't know if you can see. Probably could.
I'm using my eagle eye, so I'm looking very carefully everywhere, scanning.
Actually, I also have eagle eyes attuned.
Yes, you do.
So do we see that?
You do see, you guys do start to see from that direction, like, things.
There's a pillar here, you can't see it.
I can see it. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to.
No, there's a pillar right here.
Well, we can see around the pillar a bit.
Yeah, it's...
There's no way you can see around the pillar.
Anyway.
Line of sight disagrees.
Well, I guess
it's because the LOS hasn't been drawn. These are pillars, right? You can't see through this pillar.
Right.
Yeah, so there's a pillar. The same pillar there, so you can't see whatever the hell that thing is next to it.
Okay, fine.
Wait, what thing?
All the way to the right. See this pillar?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, you can't
but,
see it.
I will say that you guys get glimpses of movement in that direction if you're specifically looking there.
Okay, I will face that way and say, and let everyone else know, there's something moving over there, and point down that hallway.
Eros goes very stiff and looks that way.
Storm, what's down that hallway?
That way is the forge. I don't think that people would be gathered there. I think it's best if we head in that direction. And he points that way.
Yes.
Points whichever way you want to go, let's go.
And he's going to reach into his pocket, and do, he's going to pull out a ferret.
What?
He's going to release it. He's like, go, Herman, go.
You have a fuzzy tube sock?
I want to see the long cat. Where's the long cat? Tell me you have a token for the long cat.
I don't. It doesn't seem very happy to be in this environment because it's not fun. But it moves back towards the...
Hold! To the left bodies.
So I didn't make a map for this. I'm just going to tell you what it is. So you guys move into the central square. This seems to be, just from like the shops and whatnot, seems to be more like a normal shop. So like, you know, grocers, bakers, whatnot like that. You still don't find anything there. There are still bodies everywhere. Not nearly as many. It looks like a lot of people are trying to get out. That's why they were towards the front. But you guys search around a bit, and you still don't find any survivors.
Thorgrim wants to go home.
That's fine.
Where's his home?
You guys keep moving back. Just pull the map for this. Let me make it fast.
I'm still looking down that hallway occasionally, seeing if anything gets closer.
Yeah. Are you staying back, or are you going with them? Because they're going to the length of that map, like, two maps in.
Well, my eagle has a movement speed of 80, so as soon as it gets about maybe 50 feet away, I'll have my eagle start backing up, but Gorix will stay trained on that hallway, and also just keep looking around.
I'm not gonna do a map for this, that would be a waste of time. So Thorgrim, you make it your way back to the settlement. There is like a underground somewhere in between, like a pond, well, a large pond I would say, in the middle, and their housing set up. It's kind of weird for you guys who have never been back here, because it looks like you're outside almost, but there's still a ceiling here as well. Thorgrim, you make your way to your house.
Oh, it's like a house?
Kind of. The ceiling there is higher than the rest. It's more of like a domed out cave. Mm-hmm. And there are structures within that cave around this,
little town.
Natural pond. Yeah, it's like a several thing. It's just smaller living quarters than the rest of town.
Yep. I'll head to his house and go in. I'm assuming if everyone is following him. If not, then.
Yes, following him.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. It's the same thing here. You don't find anybody inside, but there's still there are a few dead bodies around this area as well. Inside your house, you don't find anything.
Yeah, you see him walk into a house and you'll just hear him yell, Kelsa! Thorgrim Jr.! God. Where are you?
Nothing happens.
If the ceiling's gotten higher, Quirks will go up higher.
Grim Thor. And he'll come out of his house with, like, just this look of utter despair on his face. They're not here.
Maybe they got out.
He just stands there.
Anything else in this, like, the housing environment? Or settlement, or...?
In the house itself, there's nothing, outside, you do see a few bodies here and there. Not nearly as many as you guys saw at the, in the market up front,
I'd like to use investigation to see if, like, people left in a hurry, like, if...
Oh, yeah, it definitely seems like people were trying to move towards the exit to get away from something. But the bodies themselves, it's hard to decipher a lot, because they've been here for a month now.
Can I make a perception check and just see if I notice any movement anywhere nearby?
Do you recognize any clothing that these deceased are wearing?
Oh, yeah.
So we're gonna make an investigation check. Oriana, you don't see or hear any, men. Thorgrim, towards the pond, near the shore, you do find what seems to be your family.
Oh, thank God, I found you. Alright, let's go.
Not alive.
Shit.
Thanks for making me the asshole. You find the remains of your family, I should say.
Alright, basically you guys will see him walk over and kind of just kneel down towards a, you know, like a small grouping of bodies here. And then he'll just kind of stand up and head back towards you. And, say, well, looks like there's no survivors.
Do you want to take them to the cart for a proper burial?
Not yet. Let's discover what's going on here and kill whatever did this.
Any blood trails, like where... I'm basically trying to see if there's any tracks of wherever this thing is.
No, the only movement you guys have seen is back towards the forge. That's the only movement you guys have seen yet in the city. Back in the beginning.
Well, we did see movement to the, I guess, east. Do you want to head there?
Yes, let's head back to the forge. Yes.
Can we start calling it the smithy, please?
I was waiting for somebody to say that.
Do you want new stealth checks? Since we, like, it's been forever.
Yeah, as you guys re-enter this area.
Okay, I will roll stealth.
This is not the way to the forge. I'm getting forgetful in my old age.
What is this place?
It just looks like a weapon shop. There isn't much left here. Just a few items.
Oh man, where did everyone go? Quirks went back to the forge.
Is it just weapons or weapons and armor?
Just weapons.
Alright, head back out.
Yeah, sorry. The forge is back this way. Yes.
It's this way. Thorgrim would know that.
Yeah.
It's a very vital part of the community. almost as vital as the miners.
You know how them dwarves love their miners.
We have some stragglers, apparently. Let's wait up for them to catch up.
I'm purposefully staying back.
We're just like, you go.
Yeah. Come.
I'm good.
That one's a coward. Let's go.
Yeah, seems so. Alright.
Oh no.
What's to the north? Master Thorgrim?
Yeah, tell me.
Thorgrim, it's... you know, it's a workshop. It's kind of where they finalize items.
That's the workshop up there. It's kind of where they finalize items.
Guys, I can see the darkness.
Hmm? What's that?
I can see the darkness.
What does that mean?
The things that killed my friends.
No. Where?
Over there.
I can't see anything. I see a wall.
Oh, he sees one.
Yeah, you see them moving around. They pass by every once in a while.
They aren't attacking?
They are not.
Yes. Just come here. Just going to kill you.
I'm not going to kill you. Just come here. I just want to kill you.
Who is that?
Thorgrim, you stop because you see a dwarven man who's standing before the main forge, here that's filled with lava. And from the back of him, you don't really recognize him, but it's the first dwarf you've seen since you entered the city.
Okay. You there!
He's gonna turn around and you will recognize him as a dwarf that was actually exiled from the city.
I like how the token turned around and you're like
he had been stealing goods and basically been screwing the city out of a lot of things and interrupting work in the city, and he was basically shunned from this society.
What's his name?
His name is Dindrin Kolting.
Dindrin.
Thorgrim, who's that?
It's not.
And, what's the Dindrin?
Thorgrim doesn't have any reason to suspect that he would be capable of doing something like this.
Other than the fact that the shadows seem to be just, like, waiting for his command, and aren't harming him, which Orion and Eros don't understand because they attacked them on sight.
Yeah, this is confusing.
Dindrim, explain this. What's that?
Oh, why must I explain myself?
Because I told you to. What's going on here?
Well, what you see here is revenge.
You did this?
Yeah. It was a good thing that you guys kicked me out of the city, because I made very powerful allies with the... Gotta look up his name.
He pulls a sheet out of his pocket. Hold on, let me check it.
It's hard to pronounce, you know.
It's... yeah. With the High Ruler, I'll find his name later.
That's a weird name.
I'll find his name later.
Who gave me some means of exacting my revenge on this stupid city.
But we took you in.
And then you exiled me. threw me from the only home I ever knew.
I did the best I could. I took you into my home when no one else would. And what of Kelsa? And Thorgrim Jr.? You bastard!
And he's gonna, you know, I'm guessing we're gonna roll initiative.
Oh my gosh!
Since I've been holding my attack this whole time, can the second he makes an aggressive gesture, Thorgrim, can I do a shot off?
This is not gonna be a surprise round.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry.
Can I have a bad initiative at least?
Those amazing initiatives, so good.
Oh, okay.
Zeros. Oh no, I haven't put them in yet. how many of them?
What type of dwarves are these? They're mountain dwarves, right?
You don't know.
Presumably, they seem to live in a mountain.
Yeah. Oh. Oh, you guys entered a mountain.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Did I just mess that up? Yes, I did. Nope, I did that again. Fuck. Okay. Gonna mess everything up.
You're not gonna roll initiative for your ferret?
Quirx, will you put back in your roll and Thorgrim as well? Because I accidentally deleted that. Thank you.
Oh, and I need my ferret.
Oh my god, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Is it a familiar?
Oh, just a ferret.
You don't.
Okay.
This will work.
Is it a trained ferret?
To make that smaller. Kind of blends in with the four.
Let's see here.
If you
looks a little bit like a centipede.
It's hermit.
It's a furry danger noodle.
I know.
All right, Thorgrim, you're first. Change music. This one good?
Let's see what to cast. Hunter's Mark. Divine Favor. Alright. You hear Thorgrim, he starts to mutter something under his breath. And these bright runes kind of like glowing in this blue light kind of appear all over his plate mail armor. And he's going to charge in. And he's going to attack.
Okay. Do that then. But I gave you an arch nemesis.
That he kills in session one.
Yeah.
First hit, TKO.
You're hitting that guy?
Oh yeah. Dindrim.
Okay. Both of those will hit.
Yep.
Of course I don't have his freaking health bar set up. Do 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 do. Okay. All right, -17. All right, that all?
Yep, that's it.
All right.
And my ferret,
will die.
We'll just kind of follow him. And do nothing for now.
They move how much speed? Okay, they move a lot. Okay. So this creature is going to move up next to you. And it's just going to reach out and kind of like touch your arm. It's going to roll a 13, which I believe does not hit.
Nope.
Okay. Works.
Alright, it's going to take careful aim, and it's going to attack the same one that Thorngrim's going after.
The guy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Man, I was just going to turn him into a badger.
No.
That will miss.
I will use my inspiration dive.
Okay.
That's a 1d8 to your roll.
Oh, jeez.
Still not going to hit. Sorry. Anything else?
No, he'll tell his bird to move him to a different location on its turn, so.
Okay. Luckily they're in order, so you can do that.
Yep, so I'll move so you can go to the next shadows while I move my person.
Okay. Let's see. This one's gonna move towards Eros. Try to touch him.
He's inside of my spirit guardian bubble, so he's going to take 3d8 radiant damage.
How long does that last?
Up to 10 minutes.
Yeah, it's been much longer than 10 minutes.
Ah, poop on a stick.
17 hit Eros.
It matches my AC.
Yes, it does. Alright, you will take 13 necrotic damage. And then your strength is reduced by 2. By the way, both of your strengths came back with a long rest.
Right.
So that was reset.
So it's right back to what it is now. Cool.
Alright. The next one is going to move up to Thorgrim. Roll real low. Alright, Eros.
Well, we appear to be in a pickle here, don't we? I'm going to trust Oriana to take out the one in front of me. And I'm going to cast a spell on the dwarf.
Okay. Which, the bad dwarf?
Yes, the bad dwarf.
Right.
Which bad dwarf?
The old man or the young man?
I'm going to attempt to polymorph him.
Ooh.
Please make I assume he resists.
Yeah.
Wisdom saving throw, please.
Okay. Okay.
He's got like a negative 25, right?
To his wisdom?
Yes.
No. Although he did not roll well. What is the DC?
What did he roll?
He rolled a 10 total.
He fails.
Yeah,
awesome. So, Thorgrim, you sink your axe into him, and suddenly he turns into a badger.
So as he, actually, before he fails that, actually, he's going to cast another spell, and you feel the spell, fizzle.
Downer spelled.
What?
You countered, sucker.
It's a 4th level spell. Doesn't he have to make a save or something?
It has to be 6th or higher.
Oh. What the fuck?
Oh, he casts at a higher level.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? Yeah?
Yeah, I actually cast at 9th level.
No, what I mean is he casts Counterspell at a higher level.
In which case, there's nothing else I can do. So, I spend my turn with my thumb up my ass doing nothing.
Okay.
Oryx is unnerved by that.
Yes. It's an attempt to attack. It's a tactic. I only need one hand.
What is he gonna do? No.
Herman has an initiative of 16. Sorry.
Where is this Herman? Is it in here?
Yeah, it's right beside Thorgrim.
No, did you add it to the order?
No, I can't.
Oh. I'm in the worm. There. I can't type. 163. Good. Yes. Try this again. There you go. Did you want to do something with him? Okay.
Cough, cough, aid action, cough, cough.
He's holding.
Super helpful. He is going to step backwards and what does this spell do? Okay. Let's see here. He's going to step backwards and dissolve and move here. And then he is going to send a firebolt over there. And miss. Tragically. Alright. Alright. Next is the shadow. Just gonna move closer to Thorgrim. Invincible. And 19 hit?
No.
No. Okay. Good. Here. Last one. 21.
No, miss.
Okay, Bjorn.
Bjorn's going to 5, 10, 15, 20. Get a peek around the corner. And he is 20 feet away from me. I'm going to use my arm cap poison. Yeah.
Okay.
Which is that. And I'm going to shoot the dwarf with my hand crossbow.
Okay.
To 16 hit.
Yes.
So he takes 10 points of damage. I'm gonna hit again.
Okay.
10 piercing damage. And bonus action, hand crossbow, because I have the crossbow expert. It's 14 hit.
No.
Yeah. I'm gonna use my remaining movement to move here.
I will let you have inspiration, though.
Oh, yeah, I do. Is it a D8 or a D6 for you?
It's a D8.
It's 15 hit.
It does.
Okay.
Oh my God. Holy shit.
Which is why I brought that up.
Why'd you even ask him?
Inspiration coming in clutch.
He takes 8 piercing damage, and he has 1 point of exhaustion now.
Actually, he's dead.
Oh, fuck. Well.
He only had 3 health.
There goes that.
Alright. This one. Were you gonna move anywhere else?
That's it.
Wait a minute, did you just kill the head dwarf guy?
Yeah,
yep, you did.
Oh shit.
This guy's gonna move up to you. And
I'm gonna search for loot, because he was a crazy high level caster.
11 doesn't hit, so.
Thank God.
Or yeah.
Okay, I'm going to revive Spirit Guardians.
Okay.
So. Oh, the way that this works. You call forth spirits to protect you. They fit around you at a distance of 15 feet for the duration. So they're, like, all over the place within 15 feet of me. So they're going to appear either angelic or fae. I'll have them appear angelic. And when I cast a spell, I can designate any number of creatures that I can see who will be unaffected by it. So any of the allies that I can see will not be affected by this spell if they move within 15 feet of me. And when a creature enters the area for the first time on a turn or starts its turn there, it has to make a wisdom saving throw. On a failed save, it takes 3d8 radiant damage.
Okay.
Or half damage if it succeeds.
Okay.
So I will stay right there with Eros and my spell, hopefully wrecking things soon.
Alright, anything else you want to do? That's it. Man, Thorim, you're just like in the middle. Sorry.
I live in the country and I'm hearing people yelling and the sounds of chickens. I'm concerned. None of my neighbors are chicken farmers. What's going on?
This one is going to... It's actually going to move here. Which it's going to move into that space. So go ahead and roll your 3d8. Oh, wait. No. Yeah, it's going to fail to save. Wisdom save. Yeah, it failed. Okay. Oh, yeah, and I roll your 3d8.
Yeah. I'm so excited.
And what damage is that? It's radiant.
Great, Scott. Yes. That was so low.
7 damage.
Who knows? Maybe these things are like
10 hit points.
Vulnerable to it. Who knows?
They should be vulnerable to radiant damage. They're little shadow poops.
So close. Okay.
Why do I feel like Thorgrim's gonna die?
He hasn't been touched yet. Well, I mean, he's been touched, but he hasn't been hurt yet. So, Thorgrim, you are surrounded by shadow thingies.
Mm-hmm.
And you fall. You saw Dendron fall.
All right. Herman will take his held action. He's gonna jump at this thing and get all up in its grill.
Okay.
Thorgrim will attack it.
Nice. Okay. That'll miss.
Okay, I'll use my inspiration.
Oh, wait, do you have advantage?
I think, does the help action only work for one attack, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, so it would have been that first attack. I'm gonna roll my bardic thing. 12 miss, I'm guessing.
That will hit.
That will hit? Okay.
Do you realize, Eros, your dice that you gave us rolled a 1, 1, and a 2?
It's not my
worst inspiration ever.
It was a really sad song, guys.
Everyone's just bummed out.
Called de-inspiration. It actually lowers stuff.
Yeah, I actually give inspiration to all the enemies instead.
Is it still alive?
Yep.
Right. The offhand.
No, it's not.
You have an offhand battle axe?
Yeah, he's dual wielding battle axes right now.
Very dwarfy.
Yeah.
And, that's it. His little buddy's gonna...
Okay. This one above you is going to try to touch you.
He casts Mad Touch.
Miss. And... yeah, that's it. Is Herman doing anything?
He's gonna help him again next turn.
But it quirks.
Alright, I'm gonna attack the one that Oriana's Spirit Guardians hit.
Okay. That's this one here.
I hate my life.
Yep, that misses. With a plus 8. Alright, anything else you want to do?
I will hop off my eagle and tell him to go attack.
Okay. You can do that next if you want to.
Right, it'll fly up and do its multi-attack.
Yep.
13 and 19.
They will both hit.
15.
Okay, the first attack would have brought it down.
Okay, then the second one would go after the one next to it.
Yeah. Okay. And then there's that shadow in front of Eris's turn. It's gonna reach out for Eros.
Not for the bird that just attacked it.
Miss. It would have missed regardless. Actually, what's the bird's AC?
13.
Yeah, it would have missed regardless. It rolled real low.
Just like me.
That one's dead.
Yep. Go ahead.
Eros. So if I have one of my short swords in my offhand. Can I cast a spell, then use my bonus action to attack with my short sword, or no?
Say all of that again.
Can I use an offhand weapon and cast a spell? Because offhand weapons are bonus actions. Okay.
To make an offhand weapon, you have to use the attack action.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is it any attack action, or would it have to be a melee attack action?
You can't cast a spell and use an offhand.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
I was just double checking because I'm going to cast Bane this turn. Okay. But I'd really like to do damage to the thing that's looking right in my face. So, the one that's right in my face and,
he just wants a hug.
The two top ones above Thorgrim.
Okay.
I'm going to Bane them.
Alright. What's that spell?
It's the one I just sent.
Make a charisma save, alright.
These things have terrible charisma, I hope.
They sure do.
And I yell out, with my powers you shall be slain. I will destroy you and cause pain. Your attempts to resist shall be in vain as I strike you with my bane. It's not one of my better than works.
What's the DC on that?
15.
Lots of rhyming.
Okay, in front of you, I don't know. But this one will work.
Yay. The other two don't?
One of them does. One of the others.
So whenever they attack or do a saving throw, they subtract 1d4.
Okay. Pretty good.
Also right. Knows negative inspiration.
Yeah. This guy's dead. This guy's gonna reach for Thorgrim again. Roll a natural one. I've rolled like 3 natural ones, just so you guys know.
They're not touching
a 2 and a 3 and a 4.
Doesn't affect them. This one's gonna try to touch him. It's gonna roll poorly. I don't even think they can touch you. I have to roll an 18 or higher to hit Thorgrim. Alright, Bjorn.
Bjorn is going to aim right at this shadow's face and take a shot with his hand crossbow using
Bane Roots bullets, or bolts. Does 15 hit?
Yes.
10 piercing.
Okay.
Does that include the Bane bolt damage?
No, it doesn't. I used the wrong micro. Look at these max damage rolls.
What'd you get?
Second shot. Guess 25 hits.
Yep.
Hold on, I just want to see if... Okay, yeah.
I was getting paranoid there. I know, I was like, wow, you rolled almost the same exact roll twice in a row. Okay.
Yeah. Alive.
Yep.
Oh my god.
Is your hand crossbow doing 1d4?
Yeah, it's doing 1d4.
I thought they did more than that.
No, it's 1d4.
Hang?
1d6. Oh, it's
1d6? I think it's 1d10 for the bigger one, but...
Hand crossbow...
It's 1d6.
Okay, well, I'll change that. So two shots off. Is it it's still up?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Bonus action shot. 17, I guess, hits.
Yep.
It takes... It's 14.
Alright.
Do I think that this thing is, like, resistant to poison?
It doesn't seem to be affecting it, although it's kind of hard to judge a shadow.
That's my turn.
Okay. Then that's the one in front of you's turn. 21. Does that hit?
No, 21 doesn't hit. Yeah, of course it hits.
So for the first time, Bjorn, you feel a sensation, like vitality leaving you. You take 6 necrotic damage, and you lose 1 strength. Right, necrotic damage?
6 necrotic damage. I just deleted my character.
Yeah, you did.
I was like, where did he go?
You lose 1 point of strength. Oh, fuck, I'm dead. That's all I had.
Can I have the character back, please?
Yes, hold on. Oh, that's good.
Roll 20 needs to fix that.
Yeah, I don't know why you guys are able to delete your characters.
So, Oriana is going to grab Eros by the shoulders. And she's going to switch their positions so that she's in front.
I'll allow it. Pretty sure I couldn't stop her if I wanted to, but you know.
I don't think you could.
It would be interesting to watch.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see you try.
Does it get an attack of opportunity?
I am moving out of its space.
Yeah, but you didn't really have a choice.
It can try and attack me if it wants to, that's fine.
What the hell, I can't hit anything anyway. Oh, yeah. God, okay.
Let me guess, nat 20?
No, not quite.
Did you subtract 1d4?
Nat 19.
Subtract 1d4?
Oh, minus 4. Does 19 hit you, Eros?
Is that after the negative?
That's minus 4, yeah.
It rolled a 23? Okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
9 more necrotic and then 4 drain.
4 strength?
Yeah. It's pretty strong.
Eros loses almost all muscle mass.
Alright, we're gonna...
Holy shit, I'm freaking out now.
Yeah. On the upside, next time they hit me, it won't kill me, because I've got Death Ward.
Yeah! I'm so glad I put that on you.
Very true.
I'm going to Sacred Flame the one right in front of me.
Alright.
So to make a DC 15 Dexterity saving throw.
I don't make that save.
Wait, did that thing do the Spirit Guardian damage? check on its turn?
I don't think so. Just go ahead. It's a wisdom, I think. Save?
Yeah,
wisdom. So he failed the dexterity, so that'd be 7 radiant.
It's saved against the
Subtract 1d4.
Is it all ability and attack?
All ability checks, saving throws, and attacks.
What's your DC for the... It's all 15, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so go ahead and roll the 3d8 damage. Take that.
Okay, so that's going to be 13.
And that'll kill it.
Did it get its attack off then?
No, it wouldn't have been able to hit you that second time.
Yay!
So we'll keep you at 4 strength.
I should note that I only have 8 strength total. I am not a strong man.
Alright, Wariana, what are you doing?
Okay, so we took care of these two. It looks like the mass of them is around Thorgrim.
Yes.
Let's see, how far... So I'm going to not try to draw myself. All right, I'm going to come this way and move here.
Oh, hello there.
So that all of them are
in the area
within 15 feet of me. And I will end my turn there.
Okay.
Off-cough should have taken a step to the left, fairy fire.
That's not how that works.
Yeah, I know.
Alright, this one, having a new target that it may be able to hit, is going to reach out for Oriana.
Well, it has to make a wisdom save.
It has to take 3d8
yes,
first.
You're right, it has to make a wisdom save. Rolls a natural 1.
Awesome. So it takes double, right?
It takes 20.
It reaches out for Oriana, and then it dies.
Right. I'm not playing around this time, you guys. I'm gonna kill
her. I like it. She should have been doing radiant damage last time.
She had a guardian of faith or something that did a bunch of radiant damage.
Yeah, but you were running away more than you were damaging.
I was.
And that thing's a one-time spell. This is
my friends were dying. That, I didn't know that I had this spell, so...
Yeah.
I told you.
Alright.
Water under the bridge.
As Oriana moves up here, and she can see Thorgrim, she might notice that he has, like, this just crazy look of, like, madness and anger on his face.
And it was crazy.
And there are also just, like, tears just, like, going down. He's just looking all kinds of crazy.
So you look a lot like Oriana.
Yeah, so we look pretty similar right now.
Except you're both wreathed in, like, a circle of angels.
Attack this one.
Yeah, there are angels around us.
That hit. All right.
Yep.
Is that everything?
Yeah.
All right. It's the one above you's turn. He's also beamed. Yeah, never had a hope of hitting you. All right.
Did he do his wisdom saving throw?
Yeah, did he make his wisdom saving throw?
Good call, good call. He failed that.
15.
That will kill him.
I love this spell!
It's a good spell, I've used it before. Alright, is Herman doing anything? Just helping?
He's going to do a distraction. He's going to jump on this guy and distract him. Is that a thing you can do with the help action? Distract, give disadvantage.
Sure. Yep. Not that he needs it, you hit every time. Blah, blah, quirks.
I'm gonna try and hit the one above Thorgrim, but I'm not a hopeful.
I like how at this point he's just like, I'm never gonna hit.
Why? It's a good roll.
That hit?
Yes.
22. That thing does quite a bit of damage.
Yeah, but it's only one attack, while everyone else has like three.
I only have one.
All right, where's this guy at? He's dead.
Imagine if you crit with that. Oh, God!
Yeah, let's
explode somebody.
I'm going to send my eagle to go attack that one, too.
Okay.
Why does your thunder damage have a strength modifier on it?
Because it's magic.
It's dealing negative one damage because of strength.
One sec.
Messed up the
micro? There we go. I fixed it.
Okay.
And the Thunder Cannon's a plus one weapon?
Yeah, I did my spell magic weapon on it.
Oh.
Magic Thunder
Cannon. Five.
13 and 12.
Awesome. Oh, this will both hit.
Is there a mess fire on that thing?
No.
Oh, man.
It's either big hit or nothing.
It's
he gets one shot. One shot per round.
Big hit or nothing, or I kill my whole party.
And it also has a reload on it, I think, too.
Yeah, it's a bonus action.
Yeah. 18. Yeah, that's good. That's enough. Right? Yeah. Math is hard. Yeah. Right, that brings that one down. Arrows. There are currently two left. Three left? Two left.
Yeah. So I'll move to here. And then I'm going to shoot at the one next to Oriana.
You can't see that one. There's a pillar there.
Oh.
You'll have to move to the south a bit. Yeah.
That better?
Yes.
I will shoot the one next to Oriana then. With my longbow, not my short bow. Don't know why I have both of those.
You're a bow collector.
Yeah.
Don't discriminate.
Microsoft Edge, you're terrible.
Ow.
So. Those went through, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I did an almost max damage crit.
Alright, that one was pretty hurt anyway.
Did the first shot kill it?
Yeah, the first shot would have killed it.
Do I have line of sight on this guy?
Yep.
Then I would have aimed my my crit at him.
Yep, that would have been enough. He's pretty hurt too. Alright. That's everybody. Pretty sure.
Eros feels like Legolas.
Yeah. One shot.
Just take around the corner. That was mine. Thanks.
Are you okay? Do you need medical assistance?
I'm good. Oh, yeah, I just feel a little tired.
I'm talking to Oriana, and yes, that's what happens. When...
Fuck you.
She's just gonna shake her head now.
Oriana,
she'll then turn to Thorgrim. How much did he get hit at all by these brothers?
Nope, he sure didn't. I had to roll an 18 and I never did.
Oh, okay.
Against him anyway.
Well, she's just gonna turn to him.
And he walked away.
Oh, is he leaving?
Yeah.
Oh, never mind then. Okay.
What do you want to do with this guy?
I want to loot him.
He's pretty heavy.
Let's see. So I have a -1 strength. Let me just fix this.
Yeah, and you guys keep track of that because it'll restore after a long rest.
16. Can I pick him up?
No.
No.
Oh, Thorgrim picks him up.
Yeah, Thorgrim didn't have any problems.
Is anyone going to try to stop me from looting the body while you carry it?
Why are you trying to loot the body while he's carrying it?
Because it just cast a 6th level counter spell. That means he's a mage with probably some pretty good gear.
Can we just say you looted him before you picked him up?
Well, yeah, if you're going to let me loot him before you pick him up, it's up to you, man.
We'll just say you were there first, and you're done, and then when he comes over and he'll pick him up. What does he find on him? Anything?
Nothing, like, super important. He just seemed to be a spellcaster. He doesn't have any armor or anything.
Any notes he went over them, I guess.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I have detect magic. I'm going to ritual cast it. Does he have any magic?
Do you find a letter from what appears to be the current Eye Ruler? And you read over it, and it's basically a letter saying that the High Ruler understands how he feels hurt, and he's willing to help him recover his life in any way that Dendron needs. He's there for him, and it's this really, like, thoughtful letter and whatnot.
It appears this man was a lover of the High Ruler.
Yes.
He's getting thrown into the forge.
I ritual cast to detect magic. Did I find anything?
On him, no.
Okay, I continue to look around the room. Is there any magic stuff?
Not in here, no.
Has the mission been complete? We found what we were looking for? The source of all this disturbance and death? And we also grabbed the fallen. Your family, Thorn.
You guys also remember that I think it was Forge was given a piece of paper that he was supposed to write the status of everything on, so if you wanted to report back to Space, you could.
Eros is just gonna... Well, first he's gonna ask...
I remember the name.
Ask the dwarfy friend. Hello, dwarf. Is there anything in here that you would know of that might be able to assist the war effort? Stop us from dying.
I will say that what has happened is that Thorgrim has picked up Dendron, and he's thrown him into the fires of the forge. He's thrown him in here.
Are you going to stop him?
No.
All right.
Can Korst also do detect magic and fly around on his eagle scouting for magic?
Yeah, we're looking around for magic.
I hope both of you get attacked.
Just a note on the High Ruler, you guys all would know that the original High Ruler was allegedly assassinated by Krindorian soldiers, which is what sparked the Civil War. Because he blamed Krindor and blamed them and was going to basically enslave all of them. His son did, anyway. His son took over and was pretty much a worse ruler than his father. And that's who the current High Ruler is. Alright, so you throw Dendron in.
And complete magic ritual.
Everybody else leaves.
Hey, what did I find in here?
This?
Yeah, it looks like stuff.
Miscellaneous items.
No magic?
Mm-mm, no. You get the idea that the dwarven kind aren't very, magical?
They're the magic smiths, though. Come on.
They are smiths. They probably take their best weapons with them, though.
You mean when they get slaughtered by shadows?
Don't argue with the DM.
I know. I'm sorry.
A spout of lava pours on your head. I'm just kidding.
Then Oriana...
You still have an aneurysm. You suffer 4 points of psychic damage.
Yeah.
I'm going to head back out to the cart and... Then...
Is Thorgrim going to grab his family?
He doesn't look like it. Not at the moment. He's just sitting there.
We'll be in that cart when you're ready. I'm going to make my way back to his family, I guess. And where did my party go?
They scattered, yeah.
I'm going to go and try to collect his family and bring him back to the cart.
So, where's the bag of holding still on? It was Zarek that had it, wasn't it?
Asmir.
Or was it still on Asmir?
Yeah, you guys picked up... I thought I said that. You guys picked up the bag of holding whenever you... I guess you could have... it was still on Forge or Asmir, whoever had it.
Okay. In which case, Eros is going to pick it up, and anyone who's currently outside with him at the cart is going to see him pour a chest filled with gold into a bag of holding.
You didn't keep your... Oh, yeah. Yes. That's fine.
Okay.
You can out of it?
Yeah, I just did.
Cut.
How much does that weigh? 6,000 gold pieces.
I do not know.
He essentially doubled this. It's going to be 202 pounds.
Okay. So we don't have anything in the cart anymore.
You okay, have so a chest.
All out. I don't know how to get out of here.
Is Thorgrim leaving? This way.
Did they still have their magic items on them?
Yep, they had all of their stuff still on them.
What magic items did they have?
Stop playing my dead character.
Yeah, that's my job.
It depends on what Oriana would do.
Smack you.
Would you stop me from looting the corpses?
At this time, yes. You know, just put a hand over your hand and kind of push it away from their bodies.
Eros will nod a bit.
Where's the dwarf?
I don't know. Doing dwarf things.
Probably staying in there.
Similar to
Glyph. Well, make a new character.
Yeah, he jumps into the forge.
Yeah. He made his character last night. I would just like to point that out. It took him that long. The stuff they have on him. Let's see if they documented it.
I documented so much.
I should have.
Derek had two cloaks.
What did Asmir have?
Zarek had, if you're just looking at magic items, Zarek had a Wand of the Wormage, Staff of the Python. I think that's pretty much it.
Yeah. And his ring.
Yeah, that's not magical, though. Oh, wait, yes. Yeah, the ring you made, that's right.
Well, there's two now.
Yep, the ring that he made. And then Asmir had a potion of frost resistance, a bunch of gems. He did have
a shit ton of gems.
Yeah, so many gems.
Didn't he just steal a bunch of gems from the party?
No.
Not steal. He took a bunch of gems like throughout the campaign.
Yeah.
And then Forge. Yes.
Derek also had the pigments, but I forgot to put them in my inventory.
Okay. Forge had splint armor, a halberd that was plus one. Both of those are plus one. About it.
Okay.
Oh, and a potion of giant strength.
Oh, and one thing.
What about the belt?
Did he have a belt? I don't think he had
the
a belt.
The belt seriously gone.
The belt of giant strength?
He had a belt of set your strength to 23.
It's not in your inventory, so guess you didn't.
Oh.
Sorry, if you guys don't write it down, you don't have it.
Goddamn looters, man. Got here before we did.
The DM giveth and the DM taketh away.
I think he gave that to Oriana anyway.
No, he didn't.
No, we gave
are
her
we... Are right, we making our way back to Nupin?
Are you guys?
Well, if no one comes to collect Thorgrim...
I'm gonna go grab Thorgrim. Get his ass in the cart.
Staring at the blazing hot lava forge.
I put your family on the cart, too. So now we got a cart full of dead people. Let's go.
Oh, that's gonna smell great.
Why would he do this?
He told you why. It was revenge!
Alright, fine, I guess we'll just leave.
Yeah?
It's a little late to ask him why.
We could have asked him why if we just turned him into a... if he didn't stop me from turning him into a badger. Damn.
Yes, he did, you're right. As we did. Alright, so you guys gather the important dead, because there are a lot of dead in there. And head back to the car. Are you guys going straight back to Newburn, or...
I don't think we have anything else to do.
Are you going to notify them that you all didn't die?
Yeah.
Okay. I think Forge took it. No, maybe it was Zarek. I don't know. One of them took the slip of paper that was handed to them.
I think Zarek had it.
Yeah, I think he did. And you guys can write on there, and it disappears. And you guys... we'll start heading in the direction of Newburn, and I guess we'll end it there this week.
Did we, by any chance, level?
No.
We just barely leveled.
Not even close.
Damn.
Yeah, you guys barely have... I mean, you just hit level 7, so...
We leveled that campaign that we died.
Oh, right. Right, yeah, I forgot about that.
So... the magic items...
Yeah.
Orcs would like those pigments.
You guys will have to... I don't know if Oriana or Eris would let you...
Are you...
They're friends, but I'll let you guys decide that.
Are you actually...
We're not...
just have the belt of giant strength?
It's not in the sheet, so I don't know what happened to it. So no, it doesn't exist.
Oriana is not going to let anybody touch them until she's prepared them for burial. And by preparing them for burial, she's going to put them in, like, new clothes and everything anyway, so all of their belongings will be put somewhere else. And then they can do whatever they want, but she's not going to have them loot their bodies while they're dead.
Right, it's not an enemy. You can store all of their stuff in the chest and the others can dig through it. Respectfully.
Yeah. As respectfully as is possible at this point, I guess.
Your stolen cart and your stolen chest. Yep, and that's where we're going to end it, so. Next time we will jump to you guys being back in Newburn, unless you guys want to do anything in that 10 days of travel. And then we'll go for
duel.
Duel.
You want to fight? Let's go.
Part of me is thinking that I might want to cast Speak with Dead.
Yeah, you could do that.
Do it.
She wants to know if they're okay.
That would be very interesting to see.
It would, especially if I did it to Zarek.
I know, that's what I was thinking.
What do you see,
mind your own business. What are you going to do?
I'm going to try it.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, all right, guys. Last time.
It's going to happen.
So you cast the spell, and you kind of question for a minute if you did it right, because nothing happens.
Was that on Zarek?
That was on whoever you chose to do it first on.
Okay, so we'll say that I tried it on Zarek first.
Okay.
And nothing happens, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Nothing at all?
You being closer to Zarek probably knew that the... His patron probably wouldn't appreciate things coming back to life, but you're not really sure why it didn't work.
Well, he doesn't come back to life, he just visits for a little bit.
Right. No, yeah, it's like I can ask 5 questions or something like that, and then they go back.
It's 3 questions.
3 or questions? 5.
It's 5.
Wow. Yeah. Huh.
So if it doesn't work on Zarek, then I'm going to try it on Asmir and just see, like, if it's just Zarek, or maybe, like...
Did you remove all of Asmir's clothing?
What?
She did change Asmir into new clothing, she said.
Okay.
Yeah, I changed all of them into flesh clothes so that they're presentable for burial. I don't want them in, like, tattered, bloody clothing when I bury them. And made them look nice.
So you take another 10 minutes during your trip and you cast it on Asmir as well and still nothing happens.
Would I be getting an idea at this point that it's probably because the shadow things...
Yes.
...came out of them?
You notice that they were very susceptible to radiant damage, which generally means that they're undead.
Okay.
So putting 2 and 2 together, you would assume it's because... The shadow creatures were essentially them.
No. Okay.